Why are we here? I probably don't need to tell you that most of you why your mobile phone is important. Now, mobile phones, it can organize our lives, it can connect us to everyone we know, and through the internet, they're even able to connect us to virtually everything any human has ever known. The question is, what's next? Now, revolutions in technology have seen the quick rise of one company, only for it to be toppled by another. I mean, just look at Motorola, Nokia, or BlackBerry. Now, the smartphone age has shifted the balance of power away from companies that only make handsets to the companies that make software. And today's biggest player, Google. Their Android operating system, it dominates the market. In fact, according to the research from IDC, it was in almost 70% of all the phones shipped in 2012. So many companies make Android phones that it would probably be quicker to name the companies that don't. But even though they run the same software, most Android phones don't look like they're running the same software. And that's because handset makers are free to customize Android with their own designs, layering their own look on top of the existing work done by our next guest. Now, Matias Duarte, he is the director of user experience for Android. So we asked him whether it bothered him that much of his own work was being obscured by others.
I think it's exciting. One of the awesome things about Android is that people can customize it and make it perfect for exactly the customer they're targeting. That's one of the challenges we have at Google, is to design Android and make such a strong foundation that it will work for everybody and can still be customized.
Will Google clamp down on customization?
No, never.
Okay. Tell us about your design philosophy at Google Android.
Well, Android is simple, it's beautiful, and it's incredibly powerful. And that's always the focus of each release. With Ice Cream Sandwich, we revamped Android from top to bottom along those principles. So we made it 100% consistent. We made all of the features easy to find, all the buttons up front, got rid of all the confusing hidden stuff. We totally redesigned the typefaces and the graphic layouts, the grid, the colors, everything to be really bold and striking and attractive. And we've been rolling out just amazing, powerful new features that are almost like a superpower, like Google Now with Jelly Bean, where your phone is actually your companion. It knows what you want to search for before you do and can offer that information.
But what's your personal design philosophy? Because I've heard that you want to design sort of a world where you can interact with objects as if it was in the real world.
Well, that's true. I believe that one of the most powerful things about computers is making everyday people's lives better. And so computers have to work the way people expect and not the other way around. I want everything that you can touch on the screen to operate like objects in the real world do. That doesn't mean they have to look like copies of objects in the real world, but they have to be tangible and physical and delightful.
Can using a smartphone be an emotional experience?
Oh, it absolutely can. And that's part of what I'm talking about, the tangibility. There's a big difference in the way you now glide through Android with sweeping gestures and pinching and swiping than in the old days where you used to be poking at your phone. If I were to start poking you, you wouldn't like it. But when you start stroking, it's a totally different message.
Let's talk more about gestures. You know, it's about swiping, it's about stroking, not hitting those buttons anymore. As Google Android develops, how will the gestures change?
Well, right now, we only recognize a couple of fingers and on screens that are small and always in the palm of your hand. In the future, we're going to look at the gestures of your entire body, your facial expressions, your arms, all of the fingers that you have. And you're going to have screens not just in the palm of your hand, but all around you.
And a big picture philosophical question, if you will. More and more people are getting access to smartphones all over the world. So we're nearing like always on connectivity, access to data on our person. As smartphone use becomes more ubiquitous, how should the design of the operating system be reconsidered?
Well, one of the biggest challenges for us is designing a platform for humanity. We don't look at a single target market. We try to think of this as a gift we're giving to the world. And that's a big responsibility that we take very seriously.
What do you want that gift to be?
I want it to be computing power for everyone. I want to connect people and make it open and free, not controlled by any one company or any government, something that anybody can pick up and hack on, and they can turn it into whatever they want it to be.